Hey, hey, everybody. It's Eddie from Tokyo. This is your cryptocurrency update from Japan. Look, we're in a sea of green. I was so surprised. I just checked pricing before I began to tape, and the top 50 projects, except for one, is all in the green in the last hour. So we have got a price pump happening, and XRP is up 6.24% over the course of the last 24 hours. You know, Hodor, he asked me a few days ago if I had any trading advice. I think he's working on some article. And I said that, well, there was somebody who gave me advice more than 30 years ago who did a lot of trading. And they said that the first thing is never be greedy. The second thing was to cost average in. And the third one was never be afraid to take profit. So even though we have these brutal price swings, I think if you follow those three bits of advice, you can have a lot of fun in this space. Okay, let's jump to some big news that came out of SBI today. This is good. This is about MoneyTap. MoneyTap is really a pet project by Mr. Kitao. He announced today that Daiwa Securities and Sumitomo Mitsui Trust Bank will be participating as shareholders. Shareholders, meaning they are bringing money to the table. And this now totals the financial institutions that have made investments into MoneyTap to 30. So this is capital participation. This isn't just signing somebody as a partner. In addition to the list of 30, the banks that account for 80% of the total domestic deposits established in 2016, often referred to as the consortium, they are also in this fold. So I think this news is fantastic. It is really going in the right direction. It has launched live in a domestic format, and we know that Mr. Kitao is going to take it into the international remittance world too and use XRP. And this is, I think it's not clear to everybody yet. Somebody who replied to my tweet today about this news said that another big X current client, not X rapid. Well, gosh, okay, let's make it really clear, because I think that some people have not kept up with some of the changes on RippleNet technology. Now an X current customer can actually make the choice to use XRP. It's not the clear line between being an ex-current customer and ex-rapid customer. So that has to be very, very clear. And also, to call SBI a client is not quite correct. SBI is a shareholder, a little over 10% of Ripple, and Mr. Kitao is one of the strongest supporters of XRP, hands down. And he's also on the board of directors. So yeah, it's not just another ex-current client, I'm sorry to say. Please do your own research if you're not watching my videos. And then somebody else tweeted, great for Ripple, I guess, meaningless for XRP. No, actually it's not. Mr. Kitao, since the beginning of this year when he addressed the shareholders meeting and in many interviews over the course of the last 6 months, has been talking about how he is planning on using XRP in MoneyTap. And I took a quote from the Cointelegraph article that came out in February, and it said that I think, this is Mr. Kitao, I think MoneyTap is great. The distributed ledger technology uses Ripple technology. In the future, XRP currency will be inserted there, and instant remittance between banks will be possible, faster, and less costly. So right now with the domestic use, there is no need to use XRP. Once that international rollout occurs, you're going to see things change for XRP. Okay, everybody, this is the article. So I'll put a link to it in the description below. Just use Google Translate. You can do it. It's good enough to get a gist of what he was saying at that presentation. And he has a lot of bullish statements on XRP, Ripple, and XRP, Ripple, and R3 together, working together with Corda. So I will ask you to do your own research if you're not watching my videos. All right. If we take a look at Daiwa, you may not know this name. Daiwa is a Japanese investment bank. They are the second largest securities brokerage firm in Japan. They were founded in 1902. They're headquartered in Tokyo, and they have a 7.6 billion market cap. And this is their building here. But the most impressive for me of the names that have now invested in MoneyTap is Sumitomo Mitsui. And why? Because they are, wow, they're a monster. They have 21,000 employees. They provide those financial services like products, brokerage services, real estate. They're really big in real estate. They're the fifth largest bank in Japan. And if you measure by assets, they have a total of 45 trillion, which is about 416 billion. I am just thrilled that Mr. Kitao is able to attract that kind of investment. Yeah, very impressive. All right. So this also is something that he did in the last couple of days. He has reduced his spreads for the FX trading site that is run by SBI, and the reductions are actually significant. So you can see he's going to do anything it takes to capture market share. And that is proof in the pudding is what he's done here. You can see the reductions are quite good. The currency pairs are down here on the left. And these are the prices or spreads before reduction. And these are the spreads after reduction. Many of them have quite significant reductions, like this one here. The Turkish lira to the yen has really dropped a lot. And what's another big one? Let's see, the Mexican peso to yen. Yeah, there was a 3.8 cent spread before, now down to 1.2. Anyway, it's just, yeah, it shows you how aggressive this company is. Okay, there's a good article. Yes, it has some problems, but it's an article on Yahoo Japan. And this is important because it's on media that is outside the crypto space. So when it comes to introducing the brand Ripple and the digital asset XRP, getting exposure on platforms like this is very important. And I think you probably remember me saying in the past, you know, Yahoo is the number one search engine in Japan, not Google, believe it or not. It is the go-to site for news. And therefore, since people are on Yahoo, it is what they use in Japan for search. Yeah, don't ask me why that we're not going to go down that. We're not going to go down that story today, but it is the number one news site. And Yahoo Japan is just it's important. So the fact that they had this article is very, very good. Now, the two problems that it had is that it talked about Ripple being founded by a gentleman who's from Canada. But I think it's really just, though, a minor detail, because it, to somebody who's just being introduced to the company and to the crypto space, I don't think they really care whether the founder was from Canada or the United States. So that to me is a real minor. The other mistake the writer made was he got the dates wrong as to when XRP came into existence. Again, I think a minor thing. When you're looking at a big picture of just introducing the company and the crypto project, it's minor. This is the guy who made the mistake. He's an editor for the VCG Crypto Fund and Media Group. He's young. Yeah, I give him the same little shaking of the head to tell him to do his research, especially if he's getting his articles on Yahoo. So what did they say in this article? Well, the reason why Ripple is so popular in Japan is because of the support it gets from SBI. They also cite the 75 million in yen spot trading that occurred for XRP in July. And the popularity doesn't seem to be a temporary boom in this country because of the clear reasons of how fast it is to process. So yeah, the processing speeds are incredibly fast. And also the support that it gets from companies, in particular, the solid support coming from SBI. And the article goes on to say that the support has been unwavering. I agree. From the product perspective, there is no doubt that XRP has what is called ripple faith. So if you are wanting to put those kanji that mean faith on your screensaver or print it out somewhere in your home or office, I will send it to you if you just request on Twitter. Give me a direct message and I'll be sure to give you the high resolution digital file and you can use it. It is pronounced shinko and it means faith. I just think sometimes those little kanji characters may speak to you so as to keep the faith. All right, I missed this news and it happened on Friday, I think it was. There was an amendment to the agreement that MoneyGram had with Walmart, and it's really good. They are able to extend their non-exclusive agreement through March 29th, 2021. This is really a good thing because it was a little bit unsure and unknown whether or not they would continue working with Walmart. And of course, Walmart is an important partner for MoneyGram. So that's superb news. And then there's these kind of like companies I've never heard of, and I'm really sorry. Maybe they are someone who has been around a while, but it's called Wise Cryptocurrency Ratings. And when I first saw this, I just thought, oh yeah, another one of these so-called experts out there. And even though Ripple was rated very high, number one, as a matter of fact, I really didn't pay much attention to it when it came out a couple of days ago. But today I decided just to take a look at the details because I am very skeptical, and I often think that these people who call themselves experts really don't understand the space at all. But I found that they are looking at the technology, the security, the use case, and the core team. And they seemingly are impartial and being independent in their research. If you go to the actual breakdown, you can see that, with this 92.5% rating, they gave an overall 250 points out of the 300 possible. It's a good score. And I just want to look at some of the high points that they gave. They believe that the transaction times, of course, are impressive. Yeah, we all know that. And the cost to send is like the best. We know that. They got a full score of 50 for that. Scalability, they just shaved 10 points off of the 50 because it seems to have some room for improvement. But they also say, and I quote, XRP seems to be an unstoppable beast. The reliability, 45 points out of 50. They mentioned the 50 million ledgers that recently closed. Yeah, that was a big milestone. Environmental impact, full score, of course. The decentralization, 25 out of 50. Now that part I really couldn't understand because they didn't cite anything negative. They said the transparency was impeccable and that Ripple only controls a small fraction of XRP. So I'm not sure why they were so low on that. But when it comes to being secure, XRP is secure as it comes. And in use case, of course, it scores 100%. Main case, and because of additional cases, citing R3, Coil, XRP Tipbot, Forte, Codeus, and they forgot Cinnamon, but they did say etc., etc., etc. So I want to take you just to the last sentence here because I think it's kind of fun. No other crypto can come close to XRP in terms of the number of partnerships they have ongoing. In fact, combined, the other 3,000 or so cryptos together don't even come close. Wow. Okay, so I don't disagree. Let's keep moving on to Cinnamon. Speaking of Cinnamon, so I uploaded some exclusive content on Cinnamon. It's an extended version of yesterday's video. There is an additional 9 minutes. It's good. I like it. I'm going to use Coil and Cinnamon to bring exclusive content that I don't have on the YouTube channel. Now, they are still in a closed beta format, so you're not able to see this yet. I gave an email to Cinnamon, asked them when they were going to become open for everybody to search and view the content that has been uploaded thus far. And they said they don't have a definitive date, but that it would be in the next few weeks. So when it happens, I will be sure to let you know. And it's just really great for me, I think, to have both of these other platforms to be complementary to YouTube. All right, everybody, we are jumping to the fluff. Here is a cute little friend, which we call a gecko in the West. And in Japan, it's called Yamori. And I have one such friend somewhere in this room. Yeah, I don't know where he is right now, but he's about 10 centimeters long. And in Japan, they are considered good luck. And not only are they good luck, but they are also the guardian of the home. I can show you that when you look at their kanji, the first kanji character for gecko, or the home lizard, is house, home, or family. The second kanji character is to guard, to protect, and to defend. So it is often said in Japan that if you do have one that comes into the house, it's good luck, and you don't remove it. You allow it to be the guardian of the house. So I am doing the Japanese way, and I have let that little guy find his new home in my home. I just hope he doesn't jump out and jump on me. I'm okay with snakes, and I'm okay with frogs, but I don't know. When it comes to lizards, I'm a little squeamish. So when I was doing some research on Japanese gecko, I found this incredible photographer who lives down in Okinawa. His name is Sean Miller. He also, just a couple of years ago, did a TEDx talk, and he's doing some amazing work. Like, he brings fluorescent lights with his camera, they're mounted on his camera, and takes underwater flora pictures. Oh, I just think it's so beautiful. And here is his camera setup. You can see his blue lights there with a yellow barrier filter. And here is another shot of some of that underwater flora with the fluorescent light. It's just really stunning, don't you think? He also has been able to contribute to National Geographic magazine many times on the back covers when there is a Canon ad. They have a lot of his, the species that he is studying and taking pictures of. Yeah, he calls his home, which is down in Okinawa, a subtropical paradise. And since 2010, he's been documenting the species that live on that island. And I got really, really lucky. Why? Because just on September 22nd of this year, he uploaded a series of photographs of the house gecko in Japan. I was like, yes, I can't believe it. So this is one of the pictures that stood out for me. And now you can see why these gecko can walk up glass, because of their little foot structure here. And then I'm going to share one more photograph of his. It's this one here. It's funny, I think. But if you are into this kind of photography, it's OkinawaNaturePhotography.com. And the photographer behind that is Sean Miller. I was really felt happy to find his work. I don't know him, but I think he's doing some wonderful artistic work. All right, everybody. Yeah, do take care. Sayonara for now. Bye-bye.